Namaskaram. In this video, I'm going to tell you three things that you must avoid in pranic healing. Never do these three mistakes. The first mistake is never energize the eyes. Because eyes, they're very, very delicate organs, and while energizing, you can damage the eyes in real time. So never energize the eyes. So because if you are doing this energizing of eyes, then in long term, and eyes can get damaged. You must have seen in Reiki poses, many people in the Reiki, they are energizing the eyes like this. Even I have done the same mistake in the past when I wasn't aware of the pranic healing, when I was just a Reiki healer. So I have also made this mistake as a Reiki healer, but now I understand, and now I have the awareness about it that this was a big mistake. So never energize the eyes. So if you want to energize the eyes, if you are feeling that eyes need to be sent energy, then you can use the two ways. Either there is a chakra here, you call it Ajna chakra. So you can just send the energy to Ajna chakra. Then you can just mentally or verbally instruct the prana to reach to your eyes, because this will help the eyes to this eye area to receive the energy without having the risk of having too much energy, right? Because this chakra will distribute the prana, and the prana will be distributed to other parts also. So there won't be the risk of over energizing of the eyes. Then other thing you can do is just behind here, there's a back head chakra just behind this. So you can just here you can just energize this back head chakra, and you can just mentally or you can just think that you can instruct the prana while energizing to go to the eyes also. You can just strengthen the prana from this chakra to go to the eyes also, but never energize the eyes directly. Then second thing is to avoid is never energize the heart chakra. Even when you are scanning the heart chakra, scan it very quickly, because you can, while scanning also, you can send the energy and can partially energize the heart chakra, but it is never good to energize the heart chakra. So whenever we do the scanning also to the heart, we scan it very quickly. We don't put a lot of time here to scan the heart. So now you can ask me, okay, if somebody is having depletion at the heart chakra, then what to do? Then just behind the heart chakra, you have the back heart chakra. Just give some energy to back heart chakra. So from back heart chakra, you can just mentally instruct, or you can verbally say the energy to flow to heart chakra also. So this will flow, and even when you are energizing the nearby areas, the energy, if you just cleanse the heart chakra, you can clean the heart chakra. When you clean the heart chakra and nearby chakras are energized, so energy itself flows to the heart chakra, but never energize the heart chakra directly. Then you have, when you are applying the pranic healing, so never give too much prana, never give too much energy to the old people and the young people and the young kids. Like suppose there is an infant or a kid who is younger than 3 years, 4 years, 2 years, something. So because their chakras are not developed, their chakras are still very small, and if you give them too much energy, they can be choked, they can damage their chakras, this energy can harm their chakras. So even for the infants, for not only for infant, up to 3-4 years, when I see, we just see the condition of the in kid. So usually when you just do the sweeping, general sweeping, localized sweeping, so this is sufficient, because kids, they already have very high energy level, they already have pure energies, good energies. If they are sick, you just cleanse them, you just thoroughly cleanse them, they will be okay. You don't need to energize the kids usually. Usually I don't energize the kids, I just cleanse them properly and it works. So even if you have to energize them sometime, you still feel in the scanning that there is depletion. So just give the energy from here, never use this single chakras for the kids or the old people. Just use this chakra and give very gentle energy, just give very small little amount of energy, and then wait for some time, wait for some minutes or hours, then again gently give some, because their chakras are very small, and for the old people also their chakras are very weak, and all people chakras also start getting shrinking and getting small. So if you give much energy, it is like you are giving somebody too much water. If somebody who is thirsty, and the thirsty person start drinking too much water just in one go, so the person can feel choked, can feel very much choked. So don't do this. Just avoid this mistake. If you want to give energy, more energy, then just wait for some hours, wait for some minutes. Then again, you can give energy. Then again, I advise you to scan and then sweep if there is excess of the energy. So we always should keep this in this thing in the mind. For example, suppose there's some person for whom you're giving energy to solar plexus chakra. Solar plexus chakra also we can energize, but we need to be a bit careful, you know. Suppose you over energize the solar plexus chakra, so the person can feel really choked, you know. Some people, they even get pale, you know, and they get trouble in breathing. They can feel very heavy breathing. They can feel that they cannot breathe properly. So that time, don't panic. Just cleanse the excess energy. Just sweep the excess energy. Take off the excess energy from the chakra. So this was just an example. So kindly avoid these three mistakes. Do not energize the eye. Do not energize the heart. While energizing the kids and the old people, be very gentle. Thank you.